from XPRO Elementor Addons. In this video, we will discuss how we can create a free search bar on our website. A search box allows users to enter what they're looking for on a website. It helps them to find relevant content more easily. Let me show you some use cases of search bar. This widget can be used on almost any type of the website. In e-commerce website, in ebooks website, or you surely have seen it on news website, like this one. First of all, make sure to download the free version of XPRO Elementor Addons by clicking on the link given in the description below. Or you can also watch our video on how to install and activate it. This is an e-commerce website. Here is the search bar where you can enter your queries like if you need a perfect great jacket, skip scrolling all the products. Just type great jacket in the search bar and bam, it shows you the related stuff, saving you tons of time. Pretty cool, right? Now let me show you how I make this. Head over to the backend, then enter search in the widget panel and simply drag and drop this one onto your chosen page location. This way. This is the default view of the widget. For editing this search bar as per your website design, come inside the content section and click the general tab. In the general tab, we have layout, source, placeholder, alignment, and button options. Let's start with the layout part, which shows display of the search bar. Our search widgets come up with 5 layout. In the classic layout, there is a search box and a search button, both placed separately in a regular rectangular design. However, in the minimal layout, you will see a single field with a search icon instead of a separate button. This means you only need to style the icon and the field itself. Our creative layout has a cool design. It just has an icon, and when you hover over it, the search bar shows up, which makes it engaging for users. In the full screen layout, you will just see the search icon. Click on it and big search bar will open on the whole screen.
For setting up your website search functionality, you can choose which option to select on your search results. This helps search engines and users to find relevant content in just few clicks.
So, in the drop-down menu of the source, we have posts, pages, media, landing pages, and my timeline options. The posts option will show search results that you have frequently updated in your website. However, option pages will display search results from the static page of your website. And media option will include search results related to media files such as images, videos, and audio files. Meanwhile, landing pages will show search results of only specific items. Then the My Template option will include search results of the custom templates. The option templates will show search results from any templates on your website, including standard templates and custom templates. The option layouts will include search results from the layout that are used on your website, which may include headers, footers, sidebars, etc. And last, the option any will search all elements of your website, including posts, pages, media, landing pages, templates, and layout. For mine, I am using the product option. Okay, coming down for further steps into the placeholder option. Here you can enter the text of the search bar in order to explain the user what you have provided in your website for search. I am setting it to search. Next, in the alignment option here, you can set the alignment of the widget to left, right, or middle of the screen in this way. Next, for the button, we can select whether text or type. For example, if I selected the text, here comes the next option, text, where I can enter anything as per my design or can keep it to default, that is search. And if you want to select icon, then we have two options, select icon from library, or you can simply upload it to your SVG. In the library, we offer 360 plus icons. All you need to do is simply search for what you want. Like I enter search. Yeah, I want this one. I want to use it from my library. Yeah, this looks good. Okay, so.
So stay with me because things are about to get more interesting as we are going to do the styling of our widget.
At first, come into the input section and then move into the typography. It helps our text to become stylish. Inside typography into the family drop-down menu, we can select the text style. I'm choosing Opens as it matches my website text. You can select what best suits your website. I'm setting the size to 16 pixels and its width from drop-down menu. We have multiple options. I'm selecting 400 normal. This makes my search bar neat and clear. Next, with the option transform, I'm able to select my text with different writing formats like uppercase, lowercase, capitalized, and then to normal. For now, I'm keeping it to default. Moving down into the submenu of the style, we can select the text to normal, italic, oblique, or can keep it to default, like mine. Next, into the decoration option, we can transform the text with underline, overline, line through. Like this, you may set it to none and to default option as well. I'm using it to default. Plus, I'm not using multiple lines, so there is no need to set the distance between lines from the line height options. Coming down to the letter spacing option, I am keeping it to 2 and left the word spacing because I have only one word. Inside the typography, we have next options of input section, width and height. For setting your search bar size is per unit. I am keeping width to 180 and height to 50. Okay. Into the normal tab, I am setting text color to black, background color as white, and border type as solid with white color, and with a pixel of 2 for each side with linked values. I'm setting border radius to 25 and padding with dealing value 2 for top right bottom and 12 for the left. Next, coming to the focus section, we can change the text, background, and border color to make the widget attractive. I'm setting text color to black, background color to slightly gray, and border color to also slightly gray. Now let's style the button. I'm setting text color to black, and next, in the background type, we have two options, classic and gradient. But if I select the classic option, then I can simply set the single background color. I'm setting it to slightly gray. If I select the gradient option, then I can select two different colors and make them stylish by setting their location, type, and angle. I'm setting my icon size to 19, then I'm setting background size to 51 and border radius to 34, alright. Coming to the mover section, I'm setting text color to black, background color is classic to slightly gray, and color is also slightly gray, with the border color is also slightly gray. Okay. So that's it, let's preview it. Wow, it looks good, right?
Hope you learned something new today. If so, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more Elementor videos like this. See you in the next video.